Season 2 of Altered Carbon comes out today. So in this video, we're going to be making a neon-inspired composite using Imerge Pro. First, let's take a look at how we shot the image itself. We're using 5 lights for this shoot. 2 of them are being pointed at the green screen, with green morph suits laid over top. We don't currently have green color gels, so we improvised. This makes the green stronger and easier to key out. Next is a warm, really strong light pointed away from the actor, so that it bounces off of the white wall in the room. This diffuses and lessens the strength of the light, so that it's softer on the actor's skin. Then we have an LED on the other side, which has some diffusion paper and a blue gel. Another LED is above them as well, which is left white but still has the diffusion. This provides some hair light to bring out those details. To take these pictures, I used a Canon 5D Mark III with a 24-105mm lens. I didn't know what the background was going to be at the time. I just lit the scene so that it looked good, and took pictures at various angles and distances. Once the shot is taken, it's time to bring it into Imerge for editing.
I'm going to be showing you some of the techniques I used, as well as the effects and how I built up the layer stack. And the first image here is the street. So this is the background. This is from Unsplash. And I have a couple of filters on here to make it look the way I want. It's important to remember when you're looking for stock photos that you don't really have to find the perfect photo if you're looking for a background. There are a lot of things you can do to change the color and the lighting to bring it up to the level that you're expecting. So what I've done here is, this is the original picture, and then I have a couple of effects to change it to make it the way I want. So this colorized black and white effect, for example, I have 2 masks on it, and you can see them on the lantern here and on the sign. And literally all they're doing is tinting it purple. I was looking at the scene and I was looking at the colors that I was using, and I had, you know, orange and green and blue, and I thought a little bit of purple would look good in there because it's meant to be sort of neon and Blade Runner type. So that's literally all it's doing, but it's just helping to bring that extra color in. The next thing I have is a couple of blurs, and the reason I'm stacking them here is because this picture has a lot of depth. You can see it's a street. It goes on for a couple dozen feet. And technically, the way depth of field works is that if I were to just slap on a blur to cover the whole thing, that wouldn't be realistic. The further away something gets from the camera, the more blurry it should get. So I have this first blur here, which is a pass over the whole thing. But then I have another one which has been masked out, so it's a little bit tighter in the frame. And what I'm doing is simulating it getting blurrier the further on you go. Then I have one more, and that area mask is even smaller. So the further down the street you get, the blurrier it gets. And this hopefully helps make it a bit more realistic. Moving right along to the rain, this is actually using Imerge's fractal noise effect. And I, again, used multiple effects because it's more realistic. So I'll just zoom in here so that you can see it a bit. But basically all I've done is chosen a type, which is Wisp. And then if I play with the offset, cranking the contrast up. So the white pieces of the fractal noise get left behind. And then if I turn down the offset, it leaves behind little bits. Similar to the blur from earlier, I'll use 2 other fractal noise effects so that it gets a little bit heavier as you go back, because there should be more rain in the scene. Then I'll just use a simple directional blur to change them to be more streak-like. The next thing that I did was also for realism, and that is to add a glow effect. And what I've done is I've masked out areas around light sources in the scene. If you look at pictures of rain at night, it gets brighter if it's around a light source. So in order to preserve that realism, I used a glow effect and masked it around the bright areas of the scene. I then used a curves effect just to boost it a little bit more. The other thing about rain when it passes in front of a light is it kind of takes on the color of that light. So I used the new multi-point gradient effect, and you can see I have little dots around here. So there's one, which I've colored red. Another one up here, which I've left white. One here, which is pink. I've set that to overlay, so the color gets overlaid onto the fractal noise. So hopefully the rain looks like it's taking on the color of the light behind it. Next up, we have 2 pictures of smoke. This is actually the same picture, but I've tinted it different colors and rotated and scaled it so that it doesn't look exactly the same. To color it, I used a hue colorize effect, which is really simple. You just select the hue, then you increase the saturation, and the entire picture will get tinted the color that you've selected. Then we've got Tom here. You can see the original picture. So we shot against a green screen. So I didn't really have to do a lot of work to remove the green. It's just simple chroma keying. You can see that effect here. Then I did a couple of color adjustments to match the scene a bit better. So this is using the color adjustment effect, where you can use the eyedropper tool to select a color in your picture, and then you're able to either shift the hue or replace it completely, which is similar to hue colorize. So in this case, what I did was I just made the blue a little bit less of a royal blue and more of a cyan, just to match the whole Blade Runner aesthetic a bit more. I did a similar thing with the orange color on his skin. I just made it a bit more saturated, and I shifted the hue by one. To add in some more emotion, I added a tear. So this is actually just a white layer that I've masked in the corners of his eyes. Then we have some foreground rain. This is the same technique as before, but I've put it in front of Tom's layer. The reason I didn't do that from the beginning was because it becomes too much if I just put it over everything. So I wanted to separate the background rain from the foreground rain. We shot Tom inside here in our studio, which means it's not raining. So in order to put him in this scene, I wanted it to look a bit like he's been out in the rain. His skin and his clothes need to be a bit wet. So to do that, what I did was I took a picture of raindrops. So that's the original picture. And what I did was I drew a vector mask, which is a freeform shape. Then I changed the blend mode to color dodge and lowered the opacity. And that was just a really simple way of making the texture on his jacket look like it's been out in the rain. I did the same thing for the right side, but a bit more subtle. And then for the forehead and cheeks as well, exact same thing, just a different picture. So that's the original picture, and again, I've just masked it out. And this time I use the blend mode add because it's against a dark background, and using add preserves the light areas. Then I'll just lower the opacity so that it's a bit more subtle. Now comes my favorite part, which is stylizing it with lens dirt. So these are pictures I've taken myself, and what I've done is I've just set the blend mode to either add or screen, and then masked it out if it's too much. In this case, it usually is. So I'll just mask it out so that it's only on the bottom. And I'll do this several times with several different pictures, just to give it that atmosphere. For a couple of them, I stretched them horizontally, but not vertically. So for example, this one here, it's got a width of 500%, 530%, but I've left the Y quite low. So that's what gives it the sort of streaky look here. Then we have a vignette, and this is not a regular vignette. This is a technique that I've been using recently. It's a black layer that has been set to overlay. Then I'll draw a mask and then lower the opacity. And the reason is because a regular vignette just kind of overlays black on top of the image. And if you have something that's bright around the edge and then you add a vignette to it, it'll dull it down so that it's kind of an ugly gray color. When you use overlay, it preserves those highlights and we want to keep those. So that's why I've been using this technique instead of just a regular vignette. I used a radial gradient effect. So that's just a circle. And then I set the blend to add. This just adds a little bit more brightness. There's not really a technical reason I'm doing these things. It's just to create the style and create the look that I'm going for. And finally, probably one of the most important layers is the final adjustment layer. And I've got a few effects on here. So the first is an exposure, and that didn't really have a visible effect, but basically all it does is take the saturation a little bit down. You kind of have to just eyeball it and see what looks good to you. Then I'll add a zoom blur. This is masked around the outside, so on the edges, it has the most effect, and it won't have any effect in the center. But what that does is it just hides some of the imperfections in the edges, and hopefully just draws your attention more towards the center, because you don't really want people to pay attention to this area down here. Next is a curves effect, and this is just to give it the color that I was going for. So what I did was drop the green in the shadows, and that gives it a nice magenta purplish hue, and then raise the green in the highlights. And you can see which part of the image that affects there. Next up is a little bit of chromatic aberration. This was added not too long ago, but it's one of my favorite effects. And basically all that does is add a sort of red and blue tinge, and it shifts the channel a bit to give it some distortion. And finally, we have a bleach bypass effect, which is a simple filter in itself. It just gives it a specific look. And then some grain to make it look a bit less CG. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. If you're interested in another composite like this, check the card on screen. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.